that there should be such possibilities in the world. It is unthinkable.
I don't think that he was a very Sunday churchgoer. It meant a lot to him, otherwise he would never have written the vigils and the liturgy. An unbeliever couldn't have written that. Also, that he loved the bells, it must be something, the Russian soul, I don't know. Because when I came to England, that was the first thing I missed. I thought, where are the evening bells? There must be something which means a lot to Russians, I don't know. I think he was quite fascinated by death. He didn't like to think about it. I don't know whether he was afraid of death, but it occupied his mind, I'm sure, quite a bit. And like the church bells, something in his music came always back to you are here not forever. So one day you have faith, the end is coming.
And so we left Europe once again bound for America, to Los Angeles. Left my beloved Senar, just as we had once left Ivanovka. Once again, cut off from those places which sustained me, gave me comfort. And from the comfort of America, we heard of Leningrad, St. Petersburg, starving to death during the German siege.
Thank you.
symphonic dances, which I wrote in America, were a memory of what was and what might have been. After all, composing is as essential a part of my being as breathing or eating. It is the expression of my deepest thoughts, and my constant need to compose is actually the urge within me to give sounds to those thoughts. I write down only what I hear within me. My music is therefore a product of my temperament, and so wherever I live, it is Russian music. I wish to say simply and directly what I feel, and if that be love or sadness or bitterness, well, so be it. My music is perhaps a long, dark coda into the night. The peace of Serra, this endless concertizing, just to earn enough money to survive. In New Orleans, I definitely noticed that my cough was getting worse. Soon I shall not be able to get up, sit, or lie down. Like Chekhov, I keep spitting phlegm into paper bags, phlegm covered with blood. Too many cigarettes. I am frightened, embarrassed, and guilty. So, finally, as I end this long letter to you, my dearest Irina and Tatiana, I feel that my mournful features are clearing. I have signed myself up for a course of healing by music. What other function can music have but to make us whole again? As you know, the title of one of my first published songs was The Harvest of Sorrow. Perhaps now, we can gather in the harvest and heal our sorrow. Farewell. Farewell, my hands.
It's just a very, very unique ability for a composer to be able to compose a melody which lasts sometimes nearly a minute and people still can remember it right away. This is difficult. You know, the song composers of today, you know, if they could only do it, and there are some very popular people in the last, let's say, 20 or 30 years. But look at these young Beatles, you know. They had this ability to give you such a simple but beautiful and strong, simple but strong, you know, image. I call it a gift, a melody. You just take it and it stays with you. There were many, many others. None of them reached the same level of effect, you know. And this is what I would say Rachmaninoff brought to classical music in general. Endless melody. And also endless in terms of that it starts and it never gives you the feeling that, all right, it's clear, what is this melody, stop it. You want to listen. You want to continue. You want to be led by this melody to the next and to the next and to the next vision. And you see more and more, you know, like every door opens and you see, oh, even more.